Hey everybody, Jared James Nichols here with my favorite lick, riff, rock of the week. So what I'm showing you today, something pretty cool. I've touched on it before, but I don't use a guitar pick, so there's something really cool that I like to do. I call it like a dead bass. I know that sounds weird, but essentially what I'm doing is with my thumb, I'm taking one of the lower strings, one of the lower bass strings on the guitar, and I'm rocking off it, and I'm creating the rhythm with that. And then with my index finger, I'm going on the higher strings, and I'm playing a lead. And I know that sounds kind of technical, sounds kind of crazy and weird, but it's really, really simple once you get used to it. The thing that I always start out with is the low string, so I go. And I make a rhythm. It doesn't have to be fast. It can be very slow. We can start very slow. And I got this technique from the old blues guys because they would have no one to accompany them. So they would play everything on their own and sing. So say I go like this. I'll take my index finger and let's say right here, I'll go to the second fret on the G string, which is also an A, and I'll hammer on from the open G to the second fret, which is the A. Check it out. And I'll use a combination of switching the picking, the pattern, switching from palm muting to keeping it open, and switching where I actually lay the notes on the lead side, and it makes it feel so different every time you do it. So the easiest way to kind of get into this is to take any note, let's say we're gonna start with our A, and I'll go, and start to just play lead over it. So take your pentatonic scale, and you can go, you don't have to go fast, you just wanna get the rhythm. It's a bass with the note, bass. So it's like you're almost, in this case, going bass and note, bass and note, bass. So check it out. And just work it up and then you can go up. It's a really fun technique and I use it in some of my songs. There's a song I have called Now or Never, or a song called Threw Me to the Wolves. I use this kind of technique in these songs and it's awesome because I'm playing lead, I'm singing and rhythm at the same time. So going back to our lick, what I'm doing on the lead side is I'm going. Now here I'm focusing on the A minor pentatonic in the open position. And I have here, hammering on to the G to the A, open G, hammering on open D to the second fret. Open. And then this little weird kind of slur, which is something I got from Stevie Ray Vaughan. You go on the first fret, you hit it, and automatically, it sounds wrong. And then to the third fret on the A to open. So that lead line together. It's kind of cool on its own. Maybe we don't need to do it. No, I'm just kidding. So check this out. We got the bass. And if I do it in different rhythms, so I'll go. That That's the easiest way. We start and we hit them all at the same time, so you're just going. Or if you want to get a little more tricky, go. And what I'm doing there is I'm doing exactly this. It feels really weird at first, so don't get discouraged. It's almost as if you have to sit, yet again, a couch riff where you can just go on the couch and go. And work it up in the way that feels right, and then you can start to add different styles of the bass note. It's a really cool riff. It's something that is very simple to do. It's just the execution that might take you a little time. So don't get discouraged. It's gonna be awesome. Check it out, I'm gonna play it a few more times. And if you want to go crazy, like me, so it's a super cool riff, it's a super cool idea, yet again, take it, make it your own, do something different. It's all fun and it's all good. Guys, Jared James Nichols here, thank you for watching. Guitar, guitar, I love you, signing out, see you soon.